asatoma
asatoma
sadgamaya
sadgamaya
tamasoma
tamasoma
jyotirgamaya
jyotirgamaya
mrityorma
mrityorma
amritam gamaya
amritam gamaya
om shanti shanti shanti
om shanti shanti shanti
lokaha samastaha
Sukhino bhavantu
Lokaha samastaha
Sukhino bhavantu
Lokaha samastaha
Sukhino
bhavantu
Harihi Om
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi
Om
Later. So, are you able to do? How was it? No thought? It's okay. But otherwise, it's, thoughts are
less,
right? Mm. When the thoughts are less, that's a state of samadhi.
But unthought, even then.
Anaparli. ಥಾಟ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ ಬಟ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಸೈಲೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಥಾಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಝೀರೋ ಆಗಬೇಕಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಥಾಟಲ್ಲಿ ಓ ಒನ್ ಥಾಟು ಓ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕುಕಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಡೂ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಎಟ್ ಹೋಮ್ ಶುಡ್ ಐ ಗೋ ಟು ಆಫೀಸ್ ದ ಥಾಟ್ ಚೇನ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಚೇನ್ ಥಾಟ್ ಬರಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಬಂತು ಹೋಯ್ತು ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಕನೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಥಾಟ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ದೇ ವೆನ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಝೀರೋ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ come down, then what is there is a reality. Reality is consciousness. The consciousness is called Brahman. The consciousness is called Self. Shiva. Simple.
But in that state also there is a Triputi.
Now the, what is Triputi will understand. Right now you know the words, but you don't know what is Triputi.
Yeah, that's
okay, you heard the words. Triputi is a maya, illusion. So how Triputi is illusion, we'll understand. Take the Triputi itself as a class. Okay? So each class is trying to remove your ignorance. So this class is exposure to what is called Samadhi. And how to remember, just like you, actually what, as you interact with society, your feeling of I am Lakshmi, I am Nisha, that feeling will come. That you are neutralized by Shivoham. Not by chanting Shivoham all the time. That will only create the mental burden. Okay? You understand? Sadhana creates the stress. To be yourself, you don't need sadhana. Atmadnana is dropping everything and being just natural. Observing the breath is natural. What do you think animals are doing? Animals are standing there. They are aware. So, but what happens is you create a thought chain in the mind. Keep on going drifting. Shivoham will bring to your natural state. Sahaja Samadhi will establish in your natural, thoughtless awareness. Right? Simple? Mm-hmm. Okay? Practice this. Mm-hmm. Even that Shivoham meditation, do it while sleeping also. Shivoham plan. So what happens is that as you do it, I am consciousness, Shivoham. So you go into that sleep with that Shivoham. Your subconscious impressions start going. In deep sleep also, I am Shivoham. Naturally, 24 hours a day, instead of a person, instead of a name, you start becoming Shiva. And what is Shiva? It is this thoughtless awareness. So in the thought, mind, the thought becomes very less, then there is no inside, no outside. It's like a waking sleep. Okay? Waking sleep is called Samadhi. Right? Now what is enlightenment?
Staying in that state.
Not necessary. Enlightenment means all your ignorances. They say Triputi is ignorance. The world is real, that ignorance. All those ignorance has to be addressed through Jnana. Any questions? Is it that simple? The question? Then why are people going to monks, Himalayas? Okay.
So in the second meditation, we realize that there's nothing here. We go from stomach, then we come to the chest. That was the second meditation.
No. First meditation was Shiva, right? Shiva.
That was there. Mm-hmm. Second one.
Second meditation, you are focusing on the inner space.
Space, yes.
Right?
Inside the chest. So first it was here, and then first was in the stomach. No?
That is stomach movement.
Uh-huh.
That's body.
Awareness. Yeah.
There is a body awareness. Here there's not body, there's a spatial awareness, space awareness, inner space. The chest cavity or the inner space. So the mind becomes naturally silent. And the mind becomes naturally silent, and that silent state of mind is called self, Atma. Right?
I did doze off once or twice.
That's okay. That's okay. Doesn't matter. So here there is no restriction, no do's and don'ts. It just simply integrates with your natural life. Sahaja. Nobody knows that you are meditating.
Now, when we do the japa, sometimes we need to, be aware, so we can say the soham also.
You can say soham also. But what I'm saying is,
within and out, so and hum. To bring us back.
To bring us back again. But it's remember, soham is just a reminder that my breath is saying soham.
My breath is saying soham.
That's all.
But sometimes you consciously...
You do it. The reason is I don't want you to bring in any unnatural practice. Right? Already naturally soham is happening.
But the awareness is not there.
Right. So, because simple. If you bring that awareness, then it becomes 24 hours.
Yes.
Slowly.
And when we are doing this, do we have to say koham also?
The koham is the other practice, no?
Yes. No, I'm speaking second about one. This one, the second, when we are going to the chest area, do we have to?
No. Be in I am.
I am, okay, sir. We don't ask the question before I am.
Just say I am. The inner space, only I am feeling is there, right?
Yes.
Okay, after some time, if mind starts drifting.
Then you say koham.
Then who am I? Koham. And don't have to find the answer. There's no answer for koham. Okay? There's no answer. Who am I? There's no answer at all. Answer is silence. So come back to inner space.
Come back to space.
Okay? So by doing this, what will happen? Slowly your vasanas will dissolve. You don't have to struggle due to vasanas.
They will.
Dissolve. Right? See, the dissolving the vasana, I do some effort to dissolve the vasana, is like catching a shadow. Don't catch the shadow, go to the light.
Naturally.
The shadow will go. Simple? So practice this. Now any questions are there? Do you want to eye like you go? Yes, that's like.